right. Today, what we're going to do is we're going to finalize our basic pattern block. You've spent a lot of time on your pattern block, and this again, it's the hardest part. We're going to first make sure that all the pieces are in your pattern file. So you should have your corrected front block, your corrected back block, your corrected skirt, front and back in the file. And then none of the pieces should have a seam. So you want to switch to sew and delete your seam if you have any seams. If you have any grading, you want to just select your size as the base pattern and then get rid of the other sizes so that you only have one size like you see here. So what I'm going to be doing is perfecting the sleeve and showing you a straight and a contoured sleeve. So I don't need my skirts at this point, and so I'm just going to go ahead and delete those off the screen, and that way I'm just working off of my sleeve and my front and back bodice. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to refer to the book, and I'm going to refer to the bicep width. And this is one of the most important measurements to make sure that your sleeve actually fits. So to do that, I'll zoom up, and then I'm going to use the draft tool and go across my bicep, which is again right at the underarm point. I want to create a point connection. Your numbers should be showing. So as you can see here, I have 13.436, and this is for a size 12. So I'm going to refer to the book, and it says that the bicep should be 13 and a half. And so even though it's almost there, I want to make sure that it actually is 13 and a half. So I'm going to use move point, and I'm going to make sure that I'm moving the sleeve and not the line. And I'm going to move the point, just move just a tiny little bit here for my correction, but keep in mind that, move on Y, sorry. Keep in mind that for your size, you might be making quite a bit of a difference. And so it's X that is Y that is moving. That's supposed to move here. There we go. Better. Okay. So now I've got my 13.5. Then the next thing that I want to do is I want to check the cap height. And to do this, again, very important for fit. If the biceps don't fit and the cap height doesn't fit, it's just going to fit very tight around the upper arm and it's going to bunch up. So to do this, I'm going to add a point on my line. I want it to be a grading point, and in proportion, I'll select 0.5. Then I'm going to use my draft tool. Select that point, and I'm going to go straight up here and just click. And then again, I'm going to refer to the book. And for the size 12, my cap height should be 5 7/8. So X here should be 5 7/8. And Y should be 0. And again, I'm almost correct, but again, depending upon your size, your line might be longer. Okay, now I could just kind of fake it and sort of move my points here, but I want to make sure that my cap remains proportional. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to actually redraft that cap. So anytime you change the bicep or the cap height or both, you need to redraft the cap, the sleeve cap. And I'm going to do just like it's shown visually in the book, where I have draft lines from my underarm or bicep up to the top of the cap. So I have my diagonal lines there. Once I have my diagonal lines, you'll see that from the book she has that this side at the bottom of the screen is the back of the sleeve, and that the top half of the sleeve is the front. So I'm then going to add a series of points on my new drafted line, and I just keep trying to add points at halfway, which would be 0.5. And I'm going to do that for the other draft line. Again, just doing 0.5. Okay, so if we were to look at the book, and you were looking at figure 3 of the illustration, the point that I am pointing to right now is G, and then we have H, then K. At the very top is A. At the front side of the sleeve, we have L, we have M, and we have N. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these points according to what is in the book. And so I just want to move diagonally. So I'm just going to move, and I'm going to ask it to move on D the amount that's indicated in the book. So for point G, it's 3/8. For point H, it is coming up, and it is 1/4. For K, it's 5/8. For L is 3/4, and you see that I'm always moving on D here. For M, it is 3/16, and for N, it is 1/2. Now I'm going to take all of those points and I'm going to switch them into curve points. And so I'm just going to double click on them, make sure that they're not grading, and make them curve points. You will see that that top one I made both a grading and a curve point. That was point A. Okay, so now I've got a nice curved shape. Now I can kind of zoom out here, and I'm not quite done with drafting my sleeve. Now I'm just going to show you how to create just a basic straight sleeve before I trace off my new cap. So to do that, I'm going to bring down some guidelines. A guideline at the top, matching at the top bicep, a guideline that's matching at the bottom bicep, and a guideline that is towards the bottom of the sleeve. Now, we need to know how much sleeve length we actually need. So if I come out here to calculator and have my calculator up, and I look again at the book, for the size 12, it says that the sleeve length should be 22 and 1/4. So I type in my 22 and a fourth, and I'm gonna subtract what I already have here, which is the cap. So that would be the 5.875. And the rest of my sleeve should be 16.375. So I'm gonna draft a line that's connected to my sleeve cap, and it's gonna ask for a point connection. And on X, should be able to draft and Y being 0. There, okay. And you see that my current sleeve was just a little bit short. And so I want to make sure that that guideline is right on my point. Now I need to draft the lines. I can't draft from the guidelines itself, so I'm going to again go out to my draft tool, select my bicep point or underarm point. Okay, there. And I want a point connection. I want to go straight down. Make sure that that is 0. Come straight across because my other guideline is at my other underarm point, and come straight up. Just make sure that your X's and Y's are correct here. And I want a point connection. Okay, so now I've got my new shape to it. Now I can go ahead and do the trace segments. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with the side here. Okay, I'm going to select the side, select the bottom, the other side of the sleeve. The yellow line for the sleeve cap, and it should say finish creating new piece contours, so you want to say yes at that point. Then you want to zoom out and drag your piece off. There we go, we got our new piece here. So I can send my original back. And now I've got my new drafted sleeve. Now some of you may not want to have just the straight kind of boxy sleeve, but rather you would like to see one that is tapered. You can create both. The straight sleeve as well as the tapered sleeve. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my straight sleeve. I'm going to copy and I'm going to paste so that I have both, again, two different types of sleeves. I've got my straight and now I'm going to make my contoured sleeve. If you're going to make a contour sleeve, if you again refer back to the book, it says that the wrist measurement here should be 4 inches less than the bicep measurement. So my bicep measurement here, if I were to measure this, is 13.555. Excuse me. Yeah, right. sorry, 13.5. And if I subtract 4 from this amount, I would get 9.55. Okay. And right now, again, this is the same, so 13.55. So I want to then subtract, and I want to divide it in half. So I have 13.55 minus my 4. And so I want to take away 9.55. Excuse me. It needs to be 9.55. And so if I'm to take away my 4 inches, I want 2 inches actually on either side. So I'm going to just use move point, move it in, make sure that I stay on my sleeve length line. So X should be 0, and D should be 2, or Y should be 2, Y and D should be 2. And now I've got my tapered sleeve. So there you have your 2 sleeves. You then want to add seam allowance, half inch, and label them. And then you can save your drawing. So make sure that you save it as your final.